Well, hello there and welcome to the Ariake Urban Sports Park for the final session of skateboarding for Tokyo 2020. It's been historic, it's been entertaining, it's been dramatic, but now it's time for the finals of the men's park competition. The first ever medals will be handed out. History will be made. These riders, skaters, athletes competing for the first ever gold medal. The temperature, it is warm here in Tokyo. Maybe the warmest it's been the entire Olympic Games, but it's perfect for the skaters in so many ways. Well, the top eight skaters qualified through the qualification. There were 20 to begin with, but now we have eight skaters from five different nations.
So coming into this competition, it was all about the United States. They led with the world champion, Hermina Reynolds. Zion Wright, fresh off his win on the Dew Tour. And they had Cory Juneau as well. This is what they took on, this incredible park, this beautiful bowl. That's the deep end. That's where all the big tricks are thrown down. And that is the Tokyo Bay Island. And then that is what we're calling the Emperor Hip and the vert extension. And that's where you can get some pretty good height. This is the volcano jump. We're calling that the sushi rolls. And this was important, this laid-back rail, the samurai rail. That's where a lot of the skillful tricks and the high-scoring tricks were thrown down in the qualifying. So coming into the qualifying, we really thought that we were going to see Hermina Reynolds and Zion Wright coming out, but they did not qualify. In fact, no one from Heat 1 qualified through to the final, and only one rider from Heat 2.
Well, there is the start list for the final. Yes, lacking a couple of world champions, but there is a world champion in Pedro Barros, number five for Brazil. And also the top qualifier from the day, Luis Francisco, well, won a silver as well. So there's high caliber in this field. But really, this is for the community of skateboarding. Look how excited the skaters are. So much bigger than medals, but it will be some contest. Well, Luis Francisco, world ranking of number three, top qualifier. And what a first session. Kieran Woolley, 17 years old, world ranking of 24, but second qualifier at the Olympic Games. Pedro Quintas, 19, world ranking of 10. You can hear the Brazil fans, delegation are here today. Pedro Barros, three Brazilian skaters in the final, 26, the oldest of the Brazilians. Keegan Palmer, the oldest of the Australians, 18, world ranking of 7. Puerto Rican Steven Binario, 24, world ranking of 17. And France have great representation in Vincent Matheron, 23 years old. Squeezing in the final place of qualification, Cory Juneau. Dramatic fashion for Cory Juneau, making it into the top eight. But there are the judges, the top judges in the world, of course. It's all subjective, but they're marking on a list of different things.
Yeah, so judges looking for originality. They're looking for overall impression, overall skill, technical ability, and the technical difficulty of the tricks. But they're also judging style as well. And the man with the maximum points for style is perhaps Cory Juneau. He is a master of the coping, just loves those big, long frontside board slides.
It's a proud day for Cory Juneau because he's dropping in. He's the first to drop in.
So let's have a look at Juneau's run. Massive, massive frontside air and a big backside 40. Back on the hip. There's the Smith on the hip. Now going over. over the sushi rolls. Now, tail slide on the Tokyo ledge. Oh, front side flip there. What's he got? Nose grind. Now watch this front board. That is just the signature move of Cory Juneau. What's he got to finish? Oh, back nose blunt, revert on the centerpiece on the island. That was a very similar run to his qualifying, and it was absolutely nailed to perfection.
We can see, well, you can hear in the stadium, setting the bar high is the call in venue. Hugs all around because he's put down his opening run in an Olympic final. Cory Juneau absolutely nailing it. Took a bronze in the 2017 X Games. Absolutely loves his skating. He's always skated everything. Doesn't matter what it is, he's out there. But this is a great start to this finals. We knew it was going to be a close one. We knew it was going to be high level. But Juneau's started really well.
That was the back nose blunt, hanging up there on the nose of the board to revert. So coming out with a 180 to finish it off.
Where does that rank out of 100? 82.15. Heavy hitting from Cory Juneau to start us off. Well, qualifying in seventh place earlier on, Vincent Matheron, 23 years old.
So Matheron getting us off with a massive, great big backside air. Oh, lovely. Little lip slide there. Front 50-50 on the bay ledge. Back lips. Oh, now he's going for that backside nose grind there. But he's okay. And Matheron unable to complete his run. Now Matheron, he's got the sugar cane. He's got some Indy Smith stalls to disaster. He has got a very unusual bag of tricks, and he's the only European in this final eight.
That's unfortunate. But the good news for Matheron is that he's going to have the chance go two more times.
Just like the truck bit into the coping there.
27.81, Frenchman. Well, for Puerto Rico, a huge moment. Steven Pinheiro drops in for Puerto Rico. Began skating at 10. Look where he is right now.
Starting things off with a lip slide. Oh, it's a tail slide. Oh. Well, trying for the heel flip. Changed his run up there.
Yeah, tough start, but at the same time, it's not about how you start all the time in this, it's how you finish as well. Now, the issues come if skaters start to fail to complete their opening two runs. That really does mount the pressure on the final run.
But it is the best that counts.
It is the best that counts, and it does leave openings. Stephen, well, Pinheiro, 5.20. The world champion from 2018 in Nanjing, Pedro.
No, this is Keegan Palmer of Australia dropping in. Really, really exciting in the qualifying. Kickflip Indy to get things going. Wow, kickflip lean. This is a different run from the qualifying. Palmer is really doing it for Australia. Oh, lovely gap to backlip. It's these gap jumps, these gap trips that are scoring so well. What's he got now? Oh, lovely frontside nose.
So good, such a good start.
Oh, the 1 foot over the sushi, backside Smith. Stalefish grab. That is grabbing with your backhand on the backside of your board. Alley-oop, Indy 360. Well, that was a brilliant run from Keegan Palmer.
Firstly, he certainly is Keegan Palmer, and he certainly arrived on the scene in the finals. 18 years old, living in San Diego, dual citizen of Australia, learned how to skate in Australia, represents them with absolute pride. Look at the reactions down there. The community is very strong.
Well, I think he's nailed that. That was a great run.
Absolutely. But where does it rank? Is that a medal? Could that be a run that in half an hour, 40 minutes time, is good enough for a medal?
Look at the amplitude of that backside 540. And just lovely, lovely frontside nose grind as well. Beautiful, beautiful tail slide.
Two top fours in the World Champions. Bronze medal in 2018. The caliber is certainly there. That's not to be doubted, but is it?
It's going to be a big score.
A big score.
Big score coming.
94.04 for Keegan Palmer.
Well, could that be the gold medal to the Australian? Keegan Palmer has really thrown down the gauntlet here.
Superb. And now, well, everyone else takes note. Pedro Barros, the 2018 world champion, four times X Games gold.
Barros dropping in. What's he got? Slightly different run from the first with that, oh, brilliant back 540. Holding it stale fish there. Humping through the shallow end of the park. Huge, huge frontside air.
The level's crazy.
Oh, look at that. Backside grab 540. What's he got now? Oh, that's a Smith on the island. Another backside Smith. Front 360 on the humps. Oh, burial flip. This is a great run. What's he got to finish? Indy 540.
No way. So, what a run, Pedro Barros. After Keegan Palmer throws one down. Well, the judges have got some work to do now, surely.
Well, two excellent runs. One from the Australian and one from the Brazilian. And I think that this is going to be a fight between Australia and Brazil for the medals. There is still, of course, Cory Juneau in the mix.
You don't become a world champion or have four X Games golds if you can't handle pressure. Superb run. The 26-year-old comes out firing in his opening run of the final.
See the Indy grab there on the front side 360. That's grabbing with your backhand on the front side of your board. We wait for the score from Pedro Barros.
86.14, silver medal position. Pedro Quintas, third in the World Championship 2019. Another one who could medal here.
Oh, coming in with a lip slide and straight off on that second. I think he was trying for his burial flip Indy. So the board spinning and flipping underneath him, trying to catch it with that Indy grab. This is what it, just didn't quite get enough flip in the burial flip. So three runs.
Three runs.
Still got two more.
Still another two.
Well, judge is marking that one, I think, fairly quickly. Only one hit.
Kieran Woolley, another Australian, the youngest in the field at 17. Phenomenal in qualification.
Massive backside transfer. Oh, kick flip to Indy. Oh, he's off. Indy nosebone.
You can already see why the reactions of those who land their run early, they're celebrating it's so difficult. They have it in their head what they want to achieve, but achieving it is something else. Two more opportunities. The 17-year-old surfer come skater. The never-ending ball of energy. Kieran Woolley.
But he was going one way, his board was going the other.
17.03, fifth place for Woolley.
Well, competition's certainly hotting up here. One more to go in the first run.
A top qualifier. Luis Francisco, silver medal in the World Championships in 2019.
Oh, brilliant. 5-0. Kick flip. Melon grab. Indy 540. Oh, super styling on the backside, Smith. Gap to nose blunt. Back to nose grind. Frontside blunt on the vert. Back Smith grind. Oh, going for the heel flip. Missed it. He actually missed the heel flip, but he still managed to catch his board. So, able to readjust on that run. And landing with that 540. Well, it didn't go quite to plan.
But super pumped to get one down. Brazilian fans are loving it. Well, wants to be the champion. That's something he's made very clear. Hero is Murillo Perez. Talented footballer as well, but chose skateboarding. Put one down in the final. But Keegan Palmer's 94.04 is currently the leader of this competition.
Just really styling everything out there, those airs. Oh, that was the kickflip Indy over the sushi rolls. That was the gap to nose grind. And then, see how the board didn't flip there? He went to heel flip it. It didn't flip, and he was able to readjust, which just goes to show how on it this Brazilian skater is. So now I don't think this will be it'll be a big score.
We'll have to see if it makes the top three. Oh, fourth place, 80.24 for Luis Francisco. Well, we're a third of the way through here. Keegan Palmer is at the top of the standings, 94.04, phenomenal so far. Pedro Barros and Cory Juneau make up the top three. Cory Juneau was impressive with the 82.15. The 22-year-old goes in for a second time.
Juneau dropping in. Massive, massive frontside air. Huge backside grab, 540. Oh, now he's changed it up slightly. He was doing a Smith on that hit there. He does a heel flip Indy. Tail slide on the Tokyo Bay ledge.
Huge.
Yeah, frontside flip over the sushi roll again. Nose grind. Oh, I love it. I love that super long rock and roll front board. What's he got to finish?
So stylish.
Wow. That was a definite improvement. Definite improvement. He upped the level.
Better position already at 82.15. Do you know is, well, maybe qualified in last place, but it's looking like could be in contention for a medal here.
Well, he's upped the level of technical difficulty from run one, and it was a clean run, so I expect this score to go up. The question is, how much will it go up? Is it better than Keegan Palmer's?
Well, that score set by Palmer was astonishing. To be rewarded with 94.04 in the first run of the competition for Palmer. It's going to be tough to catch. How does that rank for the American?
That's his signature move. That long, super long. And you notice how you hardly ever see Juneau catch his board. He has such incredible balance. What's the score?
84.13, bronze medal position, still the same.
Well, it stays in bronze, but he's a little bit safer in bronze.
Absolutely. Well, Vincent Matheron from France, the Joker.
Starts with a big backside air. Onto a lip slide. 50-50. Oh, and it's the same spot. Same spot as he came off in the first run. Going for that backside nose grind. Just in front of the set back rail there.
Well, it won't be an improvement on fifth place at the moment with one more to come after this. These are flying through. Final runs. The only European in the finals.
You've got to risk it.
You really have.
To the podium.
Especially with the level that's been set so far.
Yes, this best of three format.
Vincent Matheron, well, still a top score of 27.8.
Well, we've not seen him land a clean run yet.
Back to the top of the park. Puerto Rico's, well, Steven Pinheiro, the goofy-footed rider, drops him for the second time in this finals contest.
Starts us off with a backside tail slide, heel flip, frontside air. Frontside air to disaster. Another tail slide the other way. Alley-oop Indy onto that samurai bank. Backside 540, what's he got here? Oh, lovely backsmith. Oh, nose grab 540 on the vert extension.
7 seconds left.
What's he got to finish? Another alley-oop. Frontside air. Oh, and he just missed that.
Good run from Pinheiro.
Well, he just missed, ran out of time before that last hit.
Yeah, absolutely. Top 20s. In big competitions, but this is a phenomenal performance from the Puerto Rican that lives in the United States. It's his best finish in the biggest competition on earth.
He's kept the same pattern of his runs from the qualifying, but he's just upped the level of difficulty. Instead of doing the back smith at the start, he's doing a backside lip slide. He's added the heel flip to Indy off the island bank.
Judges taking a little bit of time here.
Well, it's a clean run. He was just a little bit too slow to land that last hit.
Well, 75.17, fifth place for the Puerto Rican Pinheiro.
Well, so this should be interesting.
What a day this young man is having at the moment. 18 years old, Keegan Palmer tops the leaderboard. Australian 94.04. It's going to be a difficult score to beat, but there's no pressure on Keegan Palmer.
Going the long way over the sushi rolls. And that was trying to up the ante there.
There you go. How do you up the ante on a brilliant first run? You go bigger.
Well, you try and add the kick, flip, body burial in instead of the 540, and that's what he tried for. Well, when you're in the lead, you can afford to try and up the level even more.
Keegan Palmer will stay at the top for the time being. Pedro Barros, fantastic opening run. Silver medal position at the moment for the former world champion. Let's see what he's got in run two.
Comes in with a huge bat. 540 with a stale fish grab. Kick flip Indy over that hip. Now generating speed, massive, massive front side air. He's got the aptitude, he's got the technical skills. Oh, another backside 540. Coming out of the bowl now. Oh, no slide, nose grind. Oh, well, he went to up the ante there. He was definitely stepping it up.
Certainly was going for gold.
So instead of going for the Smith on the island there, he went for the nose grind. Got it as well, but then came off on the sushi rolls.
He says he just wants to skate what he feels, and feels like going for gold here.
Well, both the Australian and this Brazilian, Barros and Palmer, can now afford to throw everything at it, all or nothing. They know they've got a great score on the board.
Yeah,
they're going to do everything they can to improve it.
Every run that goes past, their chances of winning a medal increase. But there's a lot of quality in this field.
Oh, that was the incredible nose grind. Followed it with the Smith. Oh. Was he going big spin there? So not quite able to stick it.
Pedro back. It's still tight at the top. Pedro Quintas is next in. Big moments for Brazil, the 19-year-old from Sao Paulo.
Quintas setting things off with a big lip slide. Burial, Indy. Massive front side air off the transfer. Gap to 50-50. Lovely, lovely.
He's back gone.
Tail. Oh.
Well, Quintas is currently in eighth spot with a 4.35 in the opening run.
Well, it's all going to come down to his final run.
Yeah, it's going to come down to the third and final. It's interesting now because there's only 10 runs left. Two riders have to complete their second run. And then, well, we're down to the final run of this historic occasion. Won't be troubling the medals.
Well, he would be if he could stick something down clean.
Absolutely, don't doubt that. But for the time being, we go to the top. And it's Kieran Willey that will start his second run. So impressive. Second highest qualifier, the youngest qualifier.
Massive backside transfer. Oh, kick flip, Indy. Oh, lovely Indy nosebone transfers from the rail. What's he got now? So a boneless off the flat extension. Lovely, lovely 5-0 front. And then going over those sushi rolls the long way. Alley-oop back air. Oh, lovely, lovely. Super fast front feeble.
8 seconds.
What's he got left? Oh, back boneless on the bench and gap to 5-0.
He's going to be so pleased.
Oh, that is that. Wow, what an incredible run. Now, is that good enough for the podium? It could well be. That was a superb run from the
Australian.
Yeah, and both Australians could be on the podium here.
Yeah, absolutely. Could have two in the top three. Have two in the finals, one thing, but two on the podium would be a phenomenal day for Australia. Some great shots of a run to remember for Kieran Willey.
He loves the boneless, does Kieran Willey. But it was that lovely 5-0.
This is currently the best competition.
And it's gapping onto that rail. That's the technical difficulty. Gap to 5-0. Jumping at speed onto a rail.
Fourth place, 82.04 for Kieran Woolley. Not quite enough to trouble the medals. Luis Francisco.
Well, so what's he got? Starts off with a big tweaked out front side air. Goes into the 5-0, back 5-0. 360 flip Indy 540, wow. Lovely, lovely backsmith. Again, gapping onto the front nose grind. Oh, nice heel flip Indy.
Wow.
What's he got to finish this? Off the hip. Heel flip front side air. That's the one he missed his first run.
So good.
Yeah, judo air. That is... Oh!
Last trick on the buzzer just goes astray, but Francisco is absolutely hyped with that run.
Well,
the energy here is unbelievable. Just everyone getting their A game out.
Not quite sticking that back 540 at the end. And I don't think it's going to be better than his first run score.
Yeah, 80.24.
But will it be good enough to be 84.13, which is where Cory Juneau is sitting right now? I'm not sure if it will be, but he's got another run. Don't want to second guess the judges here, but it was that.
Second run. Tension building once again. Where does that one rank? So difficult to be in the judges' shoes. 80.62.
Yeah.
Just a slight improvement. Still in fifth place.
Yeah, well, he got the heel flip, but he didn't get the 540 at the end. So that's the scores as they stand after two runs.
Yeah, Keegan Palmer still in front, 94.04. That's the score to beat. Pedro Barros and Cory Juneau in three. Well, there's the medalists. Can they be beaten? Kieran Woolley is someone who can.
Well, the advantage is on the riders that go last. Cory Juneau is just going to have to lay one down here.
Yeah, Juneau.
Throw the dice.
It's
back where they fall.
Absolutely. Big moments for the 22-year-old. This is the last chance for these skaters to get a score on the board.
Huge, huge back 40. Well, he went much, much bigger there. But Cory Juneau is going to have to stick.
But still in bronze medal position. Nervous rate. Wait now for the American hit. It's been brilliant. Remember, last qualifier in eighth place, sitting in the bronze medal position.
Well, he stepped up the technical difficulty considerably. He just knew he had to do enough to get through to the final. He was in that fourth heat, so he had that advantage of knowing he just needed to scrape in, and he did just that. And now he's lying in bronze medal position. I feel a little bit sorry for his American teammates, Hermina Reynolds and Zion Wright, going in heat one. No one qualified out of heat one.
Vincent Matheron at the top. Final chance to impress the judges. Overall impression is what they're looking for. The Joker drops in for the final time in the Olympic Games.
The only European in this final. Backside air, the lip slide. Coming around onto the front 50-50. Gap up. Now this is where he came off. He's done it this time. Excellent.
So good.
Got it.
Here we go.
Third time of asking. Backside grab 540. Oh no. Sugar cane. He was nailing the sugar cane in the qualifying. The only rider to be doing that trick. And that's what takes him down in this third and final run.
Score of 27.81. Hasn't managed to get through the whole run in this final, but a fantastic performance. Top eight finish guaranteed for France. pioneers, leaders of the sport. Vincent Mathurin doesn't take a medal, but he can be so proud.
So the podium could all change.
There is the podium. Palmer, Barros, Juneau at the top.
And Stephen Pinheiro dropping in. Oh, lovely, lovely. Backside tail. Heel flip, front side. Oh, front side a disaster. He's trying to up the ante, increase the difficulty. Alley-oop, Indy. Backside grab 440, landed it really smooth. Onto the centerpiece. Super, super smooth. Smith grind. Nose grab 540.
There is.
What's he got to finish?
On a good one here. 5 seconds left.
And that is time.
Excellent work. Pinheiro comes out, puts one down. Let's see where that one finishes, but done his nation proud here at the Olympic Games.
Well, he'll be looking to improve on his 75.17.
Absolutely.
I'm not sure if it's good enough, though, to get amongst the medals. Still a fantastic run and a fantastic performance.
It really is. A 13th and an 18th place in the World Championship. So in big events, top 20 finishes. But this is a top 8 finish guaranteed. Probably better than a top 8 finish. Maybe a top 5 finish for Pinheiro. There he'll remember forever. Well, Stephen Pinheiro, 6th place, not an improvement. The proud day all the same.
So here we go. This isn't a victory run for Keegan Palmer. There are still 4 more skaters to drop, but he is in gold medal position.
94.04 is the score that he set. Now he tries to better it for gold.
Oh! Increasing the difficulty. This is superb. What can he do? He's already made it harder. Front 50-50. Gap to the back lip.
So
impressive. So. What's he got now? Oh, lovely, lovely nose grind. Backside Smith. Oh, super styling it now. Oh, lovely, lovely back tail.
How comfortable does he look out there?
Changed it up completely on that final run. That was absolutely superb.
Skateboard goes to the floor. To put one down in the final is one thing, but to put down 2 incredible runs is another.
And he changed that run up. He changed it up from run one. Increased the technical difficulty, changed his line in the park as well. Could it be better than run one? It was absolutely superb.
The style, now, but the calmness as well, it's just unbelievable.
Another Australian, Logan Martin, won a gold medal about 50 meters from here in the BMX freestyle. And Keegan Palmer could be about to win another for Australia.
The question is, already in gold medal position, but will this better the score of 94.04 is the score to beat. Will it go better? Yes, it will. 95.83, Keegan Palmer, gold medal position.
Well, there we go. Keegan Palmer in gold and only 4 more riders who could knock him off top spot.
This is getting close. Tense. Well, 2nd place at the moment, Pedro Barros. Nose pressure. Well, doesn't look under pressure there, Pedro Barros, but to take a gold medal, he has to do something special here.
Well, he's got the ace of spades playing as he drops in. He's going to let it rip here in memory of Lemmy. Massive snailfish 540. Oh, really just styled out that kickflip, Indy. Oh no, he lets it go. He lets it go. He's still in bronze, he's still in silver medal position.
Still in silver medal position. Camera goes to the current clubhouse leader. Brazil fans love it. They've represented so good here. And wow, just full out respect. From everyone in the contest.
Well, he went to try and take the gold away from Australia. Couldn't quite manage it. But he gave it a pretty good effort. Wow.
Three left. Three left until the medalists are confirmed.
A fingertip away. A fingertip away. And that shows the respect that these skaters have. They're not used to skating for their nations.
Bigger than themselves.
They skate for the sport. They skate for the lifestyle. It's more of a more than a lifestyle for some than it is a sport.
Well, currently in eighth place, Pedro Quintas, third place in the World Championships in 2019. Knows how to podium, but has to do something special.
Starts with the lip slide, varial flip, Indy. Hasn't had a clean run yet in this final. Needs to stick one down now. Lovely five, backside 5-0. What's he got now? Back onto this hip on the centerpiece. Front 50-50, backside tail. Oh, only, oh, he couldn't. Oh, that is a shame.
So our medalists are starting to be confirmed now. Score to beat, 95.84. To put down Keegan Palmer's influence on this contest, he would be in gold and silver.
Well,
at this moment in time, with his two runs that he's put down so far,
Keegan Palmer is guaranteed a medal.
He absolutely is.
Two more skaters yet to drop. His teammate, Kieran Woolley, and the Brazilian, Luis Francisco. They lie in fourth and fifth.
Quintas, 38.47. Eighth place. Australia. Gold medal position already with Keegan Palmer. Now, Kieran Woolley is going to drop in to try and get two Australians on the podium. 82.04, so far his best score.
Kieran Woolley dropping in. What's he got for us?
It's
massive, massive. Oh, going for the huge. Oh. Well, absolutely everything risked for there. Huge kickflip Indy attempt. And you cannot believe how high he is out of the park when he was trying that. That was a trick he was trying all day yesterday in training. And he couldn't quite stick it. He's having another go. There it is. There it is. He gets it.
Go now in style.
Well, he's still got time on the clock. And he thinks, well, you know, I just want to show you what I got. I show you that I can do it. He was nailing it yesterday. Such a huge, huge trick. Wow. I want to see the second one, the one that he lands.
82.04, fourth place, Kieran Woolley. And it all comes down to this.
So Kieran Palmer is guaranteed a medal.
Amazing shots. Everyone supporting her home. Keegan Palmer, top of the leaderboard. Australia in gold medal position. Brazil and silver, USA. Last skater to drop in. Luis Francisco for Brazil. You can feel it in the arena, the energy building. The medals will be confirmed after this skater
drops in, hits that transfer. Oh, lovely. 5-0, back 5-0. Oh, yes. Trey flip, Indy. Lovely, lovely backsmith in that deep end. This is good. Gap to nose grind.
Setting up some finish.
Front side blunt. It's good so far. Oh, lovely, lovely Smith grind. If this could be clean, it could be good enough for a medal. That was good. Heel flip front side air. That was what he struggled with on the first run. Got one more trick. Now he's got time to get this last trick in. Oh!
Hand goes down, but nails it all the same. Under
that
pressure.
Could be it. That could be it.
It's phenomenal.
He boots. He converts his helmet over the bench. That could be good enough to put him amongst the medals and knock Cory Juneau out. I think it could be.
Is that enough from Luis Francisco from Brazil?
Well, I think we could be seeing two Brazilians and an Australian.
84.13 is the score to beat. So the thought at the moment for Francisco, he needs to improve by around four from his previous run.
I think it could be good enough.
So if he improves his previous run by four, he's on the podium. Which you think, after seeing that, the reactions as well, it's very close. But the judges decide this contest goes to them. Some finish for an amazing competition here at Tokyo 2020. Oh, fitting wow. Drama for a phenomenal sport. Where is this one
Dan
going?
Had a hand drag there. The hand drag on the 540. Unclips the helmet.
Is it enough for a medal?
Boots it over and out of the park. It was the hand drag.
Oh,
that cost
it. Luis Francisco, fourth place, but can be so proud. But there you go. The gold medal has been confirmed. Keegan Palmer takes it from Australia. Pedro Barros from Brazil in second. And Cory Juneau takes bronze from the USA. The phone's out. Celebrations can begin. History's been made. It's Australia that take the first ever gold here in men's park skateboarding.
Well, what an incredible performance. Pedro Barros there in second place. And Cory Juneau just in the shade there.
Qualified in eighth. Takes the bronze here for the USA. What a day for Cory. It just means so much. Skateboarding and the Olympics really, really work. A match made in heaven here at the Olympic Games. The community as tight as ever.
Well, Cory Juneau is one of the legends of the sport. But it is Australia, Brazil, and the United States.
The men's park result. Keegan Palmer takes the gold from Australia. Pedro Barros takes the silver from Brazil. Cory Juneau takes the bronze from the USA. Another historic day at the Iraqi Urban Sports Park. History has been made. Australia take a phenomenal gold medal. Fantastic performance from all of the eight finalists. The level, the energy was just fantastic. And now these skaters, like it or not, become pioneers, leaders, and role models to the skateboard community forever, really. The togetherness, the community, the lifestyle. Skateboarding has just been one of the most entertaining sports at this Olympic Games. My word, what a day for Australia. Keegan Palmer, the gold medalist. Well, men's park was always going to be exciting from the Ariake Urban Sports Park. Eight qualifiers from the prelims made their way to the final. Three runs each, best score counted. And it did not take long for the drama to unfold. Well, Pedro Barros with a score of 86.14 was in silver medal position. Cory Juneau really upped their level from the qualifier, qualifying in eighth place, took the bronze medal position early on. And Kieran Woolley, the youngster from Australia, also superb throughout the whole contest. Second in qualifying, gave it his all. In fourth place, Australia and Brazil shared the top four positions in the end, but the winner was Keegan Palmer. He had two runs, one at 95.83, another at 94.04, takes the gold. Australia, first ever gold medal in men's park. Well, confirmation of the results. Another historic day, the last one at the Ariake Urban Sports Park. A fitting place for all of this drama to unfold at Tokyo 2020. The medalists have been confirmed. The victory ceremony will follow very, very shortly.
Victory ceremony for men's skateboard park.